braising your arm, and the Macarena has become an agony. Here's how it probably happened. Sometime in the last 2 days, you were driving a screw into wood or metal, let's say concrete. Doesn't really matter, but let's say it was a 1.5-inch number 8, galvanized, with a sturdy shank. The drill in your hand was transferring the spin of its motor into the threads of the fastener, which turned whirl into penetration, devouring the density before them as the tool kissed torque from trigger to chuck to bit to spiral tip. Your drill, being a hand-me-down from an older brother, or that one you managed to hold on to by hiding it behind the bleeding cans of paint thinner during the divorce, had no clutch. No mechanism to sense resistance, to choke the engine when the threshold of difficulty was reached. So when the head of that screw landed smack snug against the cement, and the motor's power met the immovable, all its will bounced back into the tool, throwing the handle counterclockwise with the full fury of the thwarted, bucking against her hand with all the tantrum of an untired child when bedtime arrives. And you, being you, we're holding on too tight. So your wrist splintered like a sheath of dry pasta twisted between two fists. That's probably how it happened. Between your arm and the wind, the only escapee of the inevitable handoff of its sound calls and come on that has kept you from being able to quit drinking for a decade. So a couple weeks ago you were shooting pool, like you do, and after bending over and lining her up, giving it a couple test thruts, you drove that cue as if to skewer that ball, as if that ball was dead to you and you wanted it far away and lost forever, and then you turned. And you leaned on the edge of the table. You didn't even wait to watch it run. You knew you'd hear that smite and sink. But you missed. And that ball, heavy as $8 in quarters, left a fraction of its thrill against the soft edge and came careening back right for your casual thumb, resting as it was against the felt lip. And all that speed was bequeathed into your flesh, shook your vessels until they burst like James Brown's heart on stage, pushed their guts up on your thumbnail, collapsed against it in their torn purple suits. That's probably how it happened. That your heart is grand marshaling the parade of the shattered, your liver limping to bring up the rear. If you find that your bronchioles keep dropping the baton and your hands seduct shoved out of the marching band to go puke in an alley. Here's how it probably happened. You, in you, love. And your love, being good love, is an incautious contraption. It has no clutch, no mechanism to curb the enthusiasm with which it whirls forward. And now, whoever you love is dead. Hit by a train, say, or overdosed in Palo Alto, on a bedroom floor, immovable. That torment that you feel in your wrist, that throb in your finger, that grief that you feel making tartare of the texture inside of your elbow and sliding its hunting knife between your toes, that is their power, the recoil of their power, caught in your body.